flying into the metaverse through books and culture is a project that was born in collaboration with AWE. Is honored to interview today Bob Cooney. This interview was recorded during LAVAL Virtual Event in April 2022.
I'm Bob Cooney.
Hi, Bob. Thank you for being here.
I've been in and around the virtual reality business for somehow 30 years now. And through that and watching, it's given me perspective to kind of be able to predict trends and extrapolate what's happening into the future. And I love helping startups and helping them get off the ground and be successful. So that's what I spend most of my time doing.
Bob, you are considered the world's foremost expert on the impact of emerging technology on the location-based entertainment industry. You are also speaker, mentor, entrepreneur, and the author of the book Real Money from Virtual Reality and the go-to-market strategist behind the launches of the world's most successful blending age location-based entertainment product. In which way you help companies develop go-to-market strategies that actually lead to success, VR, AR, and other immersive technology solutions?
So I spend most of my time working with startups. I've done 8 startups myself, including a NASDAQ IPO, and one of my companies was number 251 on the Inc. 500 of fastest growing companies in America. And so I understand what it takes to get a company off the ground and into a high rate of growth. And so I tend to help companies in that early stage. They'll have a product, they'll have a concept. Sometimes they've tried to sell it and they haven't been successful. And so what I try to do is help them understand the positioning of that product and how to make sure that they're solving a problem in the market. Oftentimes entrepreneurs create products because they think they're cool or they have a great idea, but they don't necessarily connect it to the need of a specific market. And so we spend a lot of time looking at markets and what are the needs and what's the product market fit for a product, and then how do we position it properly so buyers understand the benefits of those products, and it just makes it easier to sell. And then sometimes we'll work on distribution strategies, because distribution in the VR space can be really challenging. And so, depending on the product and the relationship, how it evolves, oftentimes I'll stay involved past the product launch and try to use my influence and the awareness that I create in the industry to help companies get in front of customers and help them sell it.
Have we really arrived at the moment in which augmented and virtual reality will be able to reach the mainstream?
I think that, you know, the recent hype of the metaverse, and a lot of that is being triggered by Facebook's name change to Meta, has really captured the imagination of the media. But like, you know, many technologies, including VR recently, you know, there's a Gartner hype cycle that they've branded where, you know, you go through this peak of expectations into the trough of disillusionment, and then eventually companies continue to work on it, and the product becomes even more impactful than people can even imagine in the beginning. And we're definitely going to see that with virtual augmented reality and the metaverse, but it's still a ways off. Like, the metaverse doesn't exist, and we have online worlds, but those online worlds have to become connected and interoperable, and then ultimately connected with the real world for the metaverse to exist. And we're still 5 or 10 years away from that. And so I think virtual reality is still being applied in many vertical markets. It's solving lots of problems. It's going to be the next gaming platform. And so we'll see virtual reality continue to grow in the consumer markets. Augmented reality will follow that because the technical challenges are harder, and the metaverse is still way in the horizon. I think 5 or 10 years from now, hopefully we'll start to see these online worlds connect. But this is probably a 15 or 20 year game that we're playing.
Tell us something about your experience managing XR arts and entertainment programs for Amusement Expo in Las Vegas and VR Days in Amsterdam.
So I've had the pleasure of helping curate a couple of conferences, one in America we call the location-based VR summit, and also the arts and entertainment track at VR Days in Amsterdam. And I think for me, originally it was about connecting the VR community with more commercial opportunities, because what I saw in the early days of XR were a lot of suppliers trying to sell VR to each other and nobody was buying anything. And there was a whole community of amusement and entertainment operators who were looking for new solutions. And so by connecting them together at the VR Summit in Las Vegas, we've actually helped the industry kind of take off. And now you're seeing VR being deployed at family entertainment centers and bowling alleys and movie theaters. And I like to think that some of that was because of that connection that we made. I think, at VR Days has been more around art, and one of the challenges, and this is something I'm still thinking about, is how do we create opportunities for some of these great artistic projects that aren't necessarily commercially viable, but give them an audience. And if we build more location-based VR centers that, can we dedicate some percentage of that space, time, an audience to showcase attractions that are more artistic but less commercial, so they're seen in places beyond film festivals, which right now seems to be the only place they get any traction, and I think we can build a bigger audience for them.
You wrote a book called Real Money from Virtual Reality, which will be available on Amazon. Writing a book means putting concept on paper that become a guide for future generations. But stopping the world of technology is actually nearly impossible. Do you think it's necessary to start creating a culture of the metaverse, leaving written traces?
Yeah, I wrote a book called Real Money from Virtual Reality, which was really a go-to-market strategy book. I took the programs that I run for with companies and kind of documented it for people who couldn't afford to bring me in for any number of reasons, or maybe we just couldn't connect because of location. And I give them the tools and frameworks that I use in live workshops to try to help them, get an edge up in the market. And I went back recently and was going to record it as an audiobook, and I started reading it, and I realized it was so out of date, and it was only really 3 years old. And so I think the concept of books and writing about technologies that are evolving as rapidly as modern technologies are, by the time you print it, it's almost obsolete, which is, I think, why we're seeing so many blogs and Medium posts and LinkedIn and other forums that are more fluid, where you can continually update your thought leadership and keep it current. Who knows, I think books still have their place, but I do question the validity of writing books about technology that changes, every year.
Can you make some prediction for the future? What do you think of the metaverse?
So my predictions for the future and the metaverse, I think this is a hard one. Look, the reality is nobody knows what's coming, because we're inventing new technology and people will build on other people's innovations and they'll evolve. Nobody, when Steve Jobs unveiled the iPhone, nobody expected Uber or Airbnb or Instagram for that matter, right? And so it's going to be really fascinating to see what the creator community creates out of the tools that are being built by big companies and building new infrastructure. I do think the impact of the metaverse will be far beyond what anyone is thinking and what we can imagine. And I do have concerns about what it means for how we live a human experience. Like, what does humanity mean? What is real? It's going to force us to really question reality. And what does it mean for something to be real? And I think those are interesting philosophical conversations that are going to become really super relevant to everyone over the next 5, 10, 20 years.
Tell me about your plans for the future. I want to know all the secrets you haven't told anyone yet.
So what are my plans for the future? I think I'm going to run for president of the metaverse. It was kind of started out as a joke this week at the Visionary Think Tank and on the panel when we were talking about it. But one of the things that we did talk about was this need for an ethical framework and maybe even a governmental body, because if the metaverse is a world where we live, Regardless of how much time you think we're going to spend there, if it's a world where we come together, it needs to be cross-boundary, it needs to be cross-cultural, it needs to be inclusive, it needs to be ethical, it needs to be values-based. And ultimately, governments are set up to create and enforce those frameworks. And I think that that needs to happen for the metaverse. And you know, I kind of joke about the president of the metaverse, but I am going to continue to talk about how do we solve these issues and how do we get ahead of them rather than legislate in from behind, because the technology is growing exponentially, but the legal frameworks that we use are not growing at all. They're still hundreds of years old and they're not evolving fast enough. And so I think we need to get ahead of that. And I think, I suspect I'll be spending a lot of time working on that in the future.
Thank you, Bob Cooney. My name is Cecilia Lascialfari, co-founder of Area6.com, creative technologist, aspiring journalist and organizer of Illuminati Florence event. And also flying into the metaverse through books and culture. Bye-bye.
Go. Cool. Okay. Well, it's what I said, so, but I appreciate that. Yeah. Good questions, by the way. Thank you. Yeah, interesting. Let me know when you're ready. Yeah, maybe books are obsolete. Predictions for the future. Okay. Plans for the future. Yeah, thank you. Really good questions.